and we are back with race 10 on day 2 of the Kite Foil League event number 1 in Northern California. Again, lining up for race 10 start here. We are on our final approach. Kiters approaching the line. As you can see on the left-hand side of your screen, their kites will dip. That orange flag is the start flag, so when that drops, we are off and racing, and kiters already struggling to get off the line. As kiters go down, flag drops. Everyone looks all clear. That first kite was quite close to the line. That looks to be Daniela Maras on that gray and green kite. She looks to be leading off the line here. We'll see if she can hold this speed. Now, she is a bit lighter of a kiter, just being female compared to some of these big built heavy dudes out here. That yellow kite on top of her, Marcus Edegren, currently leading the event coming into today. We'll see how he can hold this lane. He's in a tight spot with Johnny Heineken in the blue kite just on top of him. They're fighting hard for this lane. Daniela does look to have lost a little bit of speed there. You can see that's probably just a weight differential. Maybe she's on a different size kite. It's hard to see. We'll have to get that data for you coming at you shortly. But Johnny Heineken tacking off here in the blue kite. Daniela Miraz still going, and Marcus Edegren holding on her hip nicely, almost looking at a roll here, but he brings his wing up. He might have been almost shaved there, because he goes for the tack unless he wanted to get right and stay with Johnny, who had already tacked off. Daniela tacking to match there. She's got a nice clean lane there. At least she doesn't have to be worrying about getting rolled anymore. Marcus Edegren there, you see, on the yellow kite, and this closer gray and green kite is Will Sear matching Daniela Miraz, coming up and over the top. Again, Daniela looking in trouble here as she's in a really, really tight lane, sandwiched between that yellow kite, Marcus Edegren, current event leader, and another top kiter here, top athlete, Will Sear, almost rolling over the top of her, able to power through in that puff. Some of these big guys, they're able. It's a lot breezier today. Breeze up in 18 knot to 20 knot range. These guys are absolutely flying upwind, and having weight is definitely to your advantage. If you can keep the drag down on your kite, you can fly that much faster. You can see how fast these guys are going on the far side of your course there as they blow by these channel markers. Now, it's important to note the course is laid across a channel. We shouldn't have any ships coming down today on the schedule. But coming down on the bottom of your screen here is Santos Villegas from La Ventana in Mexico coming across. He may be this race leader almost, except, he looks as though he's going to have to duck in the blue. Johnny Heineken coming across there on starboard, having right away. Santos ducking Johnny Heineken. And that other blue kite coming across, Neil Marcellini there, chasing that top pack right on their heels. Johnny Heineken zooming in close here on Johnny Heineken as he comes out to this port hand ley line almost, or he looks just shy of ley line. He goes for his final tack into the mark. Currently leading Will Sear on that gray and green kite, but right on his heels is Marcus Edegren in the yellow. Cruising into Mark 1. They do look like they're laying. Yep, there goes Will Sear with a nice rounding, but it's Marcus Edegren right on his heels and looking with a nice tight exit, ready to jibe on top of him onto the downwind. Marcus Edegren in that with that yellow kite and orange bib on. As we zoom and pan over here to the race for third place in this race, this is Santos Villegas and Daniela Miraz hot on his heels. We're going to follow Daniela here if we can, right down with Santos Villegas chasing him. Johnny Heineken hot on Daniela's heels. I'm sure they've done some training together, just knowing their names from past kiting, both kiting world champions, foil kite world champions, here at this Kite Foil League event number 1. Daniela going for a nice, smooth and controlled jibes despite these massive puffs. You can see on the screen there some massive streaks coming down as the breeze drops off the land there into the water. Now, there's not a whole lot of shift going on, but there is a bit of wind shear as it comes off the shore. That's Will Sear now back just in outside of that top three. Will Sear jibing, or sorry, this is your top two. Will Sear in the lead here, it looks like, as that was Marcus Edegren who just dropped his kite slightly and looked like he went slightly in the drink. If he has another jibe like that, he might just let Will Sear run away with this race. But he does look as though he's absolutely baked in coming downwind here. He looks deeper and faster as he approaches Will Sear here, coming in to the leeward mark. You can see the speed these guys are doing, absolutely flying up over 25 knots easy, possibly over 30, 35 knots as they come downwind here. They're on their smaller kites. It is quite breezy today. Breeze at least 16 in the lulls. So as we come down into the leeward mark, again, it's a two-lap race, up, down, and actually the finish is a tight reach across the finish. So as we come into these gates here, again, it's Will Sear on that gray and green kite in the lead, puts his kite up, ready to round this mark. Oh, sorry, that's into a jibe he goes as we come into the mark there. That he's likely on final approach as Marcus Ettergren goes for the duck. A quick duck on him. He's on port. He has to avoid Will Sear. Will Sear going for the split. Takes the right gate looking downwind, left gate looking upwind. I would assume that off screen to your left was Marcus Ettergren, who just rounded the opposite gate going for the split. But no, I'm wrong. He decided to come back and actually looks like he struggled a bit with his rounding there. That might put him back further. Actually, that's not Marcus. That's an orange kite. Sorry, I'm colorblind here. That's Santos Villegas clawing back towards Will Sear here. And they're slowly trying to rein in Will Sear. This is Neil Marcinelli now coming downwind, trying to bite back in this race. He struggled a bit on that first upwind after a rough start, but he is slowly clawing back into this race, as you can see. Now back to the leaders. Will Sear coming across course center, but coming across in the forefront of your screen there as other guys, the tail end of the fleet, are coming down. This is going to be a really tight cross between Will Sear in the gray and Marcus Ettergren on the right-hand side with that yellow kite. Behind them, Johnny Heineken in that blue kite, smaller, but coming across the screen from the right. He's clearly behind the both of them, but hot on their heels. And again, don't forget Santos Villegas, coming across from the left-hand side, not on screen. Will Sear looking like he has the cross there fairly easily. He's still got a couple boat length lead. Santos Villegas coming across on the right-hand side of your screen there, course left to course right, as they potentially get to ley line out on that right-hand side. That's Will Sear going for attack on the very top of your screen there, out towards the shoreline. Again, these channel markers, we're going through the channel, but it's very deep right up until the shore, but there are some weed patches, as you can see, going across your screen at points. You can see the white caps out here. The chop does build up a little bit, so it's important to note that this is really tough racing. These guys are pushing it to the limit, trying to get as low to the water as possible, but that might be one thing that actually is helping Will Sear. You see Marcus Ettergren going for attack there. Again, this might be helping Will Sear a bit. We saw him with a bit radical of a board design yesterday, going for some planing steps, which just helps his board get up and over those waves in the choppier conditions, to my knowledge. Again, not necessarily a kiter here, but I would say that's probably going to help in choppier conditions compared to flatter, because you can get close to the water without worrying about clipping the board on the water and stalling you down. So you see Will Sear, he must be worried there a bit about the right, because he did lose a bit there. He's matching tacks onto the top of Marcus Ettergren in the yellow kite. We could have some action here. Will Sear goes for the tack. Marcus Ettergren to match. They come back on what should be starboard ley line here, coming into the top mark. And it's Santos Villegas clawing back. Very nice gains from him as he narrows down the lead on the top two. He might be able to apply some pressure here coming on to this downwind so that they can't just be in a battle for the one or two, but it's a battle one, two, or three. Again, Will Sear leading coming into this top mark, it looks like, but no, he's going to have to shoot up, possibly going for a double tack, and we have a major wipeout there at the windward mark that looked like Will Sear, and Marcus Ettergren takes the lead in the yellow. Will Sear stalled at the mark that looked like a pretty intense crash. Behind him in the blue is Johnny Heineken. Now, Santos Villegas, he looked like he struggled a bit there. I didn't quite see it in that whitewash that happened. But Santos Villegas, coming downwind in third, right on Johnny Heineken's heels. Again, it looked as though Marcus Ettergren going to be able to run away with this one unless something bad happens on the downhill. Will Sear having an absolute mare of a rounding there, going in the one, losing to the four. Again, that's that type of pressure that those guys are applying by being right on their heels coming into that mark. This is Santos Villegas. In the orange kite, and on the blue is Johnny Heineken. This is the battle for second place right here. Again, Marcus Ettergren leading on the yellow kite. It looks as though he is comfortably in the lead now, and this is the final downwind, but it could be tight. We just saw what happened when pressure is applied and you stay pushing. Sometimes we see these guys in second and third pushing each other so hard as we go into a potential jibing duel here. Oh, we're floating high to Match, trying to get over the top here, and it's Xanthos Riegas jibing early on the orange kite, matching Johnny Heineken, trying to get up and over the top. He's trying to apply some cover here, get into a puff, and he'll be able to drive right down over the top. And this is the kind of stuff when you apply that pressure behind, sometimes they can reel in someone who's ahead and comfortably and sort of shutting off mentally in their race and just casually cruising at the front. So we'll see if they're able to reel in Marcus Edegren in this final bit as we come into the downwind. Again, they have to round the pin as they come into the finish. This looks to be, yep, this is Daniela Maras back in the race, about probably fourth or fifth place, depending on what happened to Will Sear. We didn't quite get that. We'll try to get that information to you very shortly. This is Daniela Maras cruising downwind on the course left, right-hand side of the downwind. She's just doing some smooth jibes through there, but back to the leaders. This looks to be Marcus Edegren in the lead still. He looks to have almost extended. And again, it's Johnny Heineken still holding off second place. Xanthos Riegas coming in third, it looks like, but we've seen some gnarly wipeouts coming out of this reach mark into the finish. Now, the finish will clear probably on the left-hand side of your screen there. There it is. You see the committee boat. They have to reach across there. They're not done until they finish it. Coming in nice and easy with the lead is Marcus Edegren taking the bullet on race number 10. Johnny Heineken in second on that blue kite and rounding out your top three. Xanthos Riegas putting on an epic battle there, fighting for second. Again, just back after they've rounded out your top three. This looks like the battle for fourth place. So to almost make that podium, this is Will Sear and Evan Heffernan coming in. And Will Sear kooks it at the mark. Absolutely botches his jibe coming in. Evan Heffernan flies by him to take what should be fourth place. Was sixth. But either way, that was an absolute kook by Will Sear. Hopefully he's okay after that recovery. That looked like a tough jibe there. He might have just clipped his tip on some weeds or something. And that was an epic race. We will be back with you for race number 11 shortly.